think it's W.C. Fields. In San Francisco. One more flight to Hawaii. 5.5 hours. I'm so tired. I've got a gale in my sail. Another hour to the timeshare. We've been up for how long?
Probably 22 hours.
22 hours. Nah, here he is. Weather's great. Ocean is right there. All the birds are new. The flowers. There are way too many people. I mean, this is a resort. Wow. Now that's some sandstone there. I'll add the music later and it'll be like.
Yeah. Wow, I think my mom was driving this up really high.
Exploring the island, looking around. I'm a tourist in Hawaii, everybody get down. Cone action. Cones are universal.
Wow.
Giant mountain in the distance. That's what I'm saying. But like we discussed, we could just live in California and get the mainland experience and the island escapist lifestyle that I crave so dearly. Ooh. That's a cool house.
Yeah,
look at that.
In a greenhouse.
Oh, the lizard. The little guy. Maui, checking out the blowhole. You alright? Cool volcanic rock here. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, those waves are monstrous. Woo! Wow. Realest rainbow there is. Hi there.
What?
Yeah, I'm gonna go down.
Yeah, try it.
Whoa, it's soft. chilly. Well, it was my first day in Maui. Awesome. It's weird. It's weird being on an island in the middle of the Pacific. It's like, what? But it's beautiful. It's so beautiful, and the animals are cool, and the plants are cool, and it's new. It's weird being in a place that's so accommodating for tourism, as well as just exorbitant amounts of wealth. This makes me wonder what, who's being displaced by this sort of wealth? Are people benefiting from the situation? Overall, people seem to be pretty happy here. Everyone seems to be in a great mood. Today, we mostly just kind of explored. We're on the western side of Maui. I think the resort we're at is Ka'anapali. That's the town, maybe? It's great, right? The ocean's right out there. Seeing all sorts of cool birds today. I saw mynah birds. Mynah birds are like the trash bird of Hawaii, which is great because they're really cool. Even saw lots of house sparrows. Also saw Java sparrows, red-crested cardinals, lots of cool doves. I think they're like spotted doves or zebra doves. We went to this place called the Blowhole, the Nakalele Blowhole, where it's just this opening in this volcanic rock that when the waves come in, it shoots water straight up. Yeah, super cool. Really good stuff. And it's just day one, so I'll be seeing y'all later. Aloha. Good morning, and welcome to Matt Becker Video. Another beautiful day in Hawaii. I'm telling them I'm really sad to leave. I mean, look at this. Today we're going out into that water on an outrigger, sort of like a canoe. I don't know if I'll be able to get footage, because chances are I'll get very wet. I got my rash guard to protect myself. These islands are so fascinating. We were discussing that they're probably the youngest land masses on the Earth. Very recent volcanoes. Basically, there's a plume of magma underneath this oceanic plate, and periodically would spurt up these huge mountains. These, like, the Hawaiian Islands are basically Everest-sized mountains. And just years and years of volcanoes, finally the peaks rise out of the water. And then slowly the plates shift, and you end up seeing a series of islands in a line as the plumes keep rising and the plates keep shifting over the plume. So here we see the giant banyan tree, and as you can see, the limbs grow back into the ground and start new trees. So it's just one big network of one tree. Pretty cool. Thank you.
They travel and travel and travel.
So I was flying around my quadcopter in this field here. Let me take a look all around. And I lost it in this slightly mowed grass. It's like I feel like I saw where it fell. But gosh, this is just quite a visual problem. There's no way it came out here, did it? It's getting really hot too. Oh, I really have no idea where to put this. This is the sunset. We are on a boat looking at the sunset. Island life on a boat called the appetizer boat.
This is the Becker block.
We do it for the likes and the subscribe.
Do it for the likes and subscribe. Oh, okay.
Get the whole family.
Not like. Do it for the likes and subscribe.
Look at this nonsense. It's beautiful. Like, shouldn't be allowed. I mean, tourism, there's definitely something wrong about it, but it employs a lot of people. People spend a lot of money. I kind of want some gelato. Look at these plants. Look at this bead. Look at this snail. There are snails all over the yard. Here's another. Here's another. There's more. There's more snails. Here's another. Here's another. Well, you didn't think I'd find you, but I did. How did they get out here? How long did it take him to get out here? And that's snail vision.
Oh, there are two of them.
I think there's three. Oh, they're in their holes. Oh, they just went in the holes.
Oh.
Oh. Hey, look, a corn dog. Well, it's day three here in Maui. It's interesting, I mean, whenever you go to a new place, you always expect that things might be a certain way. And yeah, things are definitely different than I expected and in other ways better than I expected. So today I think we're gonna try and make a day trip to the other side of the island, to the national park there. Apparently there's a cool, like, caldera crater, some good hiking. I'm really excited to see what that looks like. Yesterday we went out on the outrigger, and that was a really cool experience, especially because the guys were local Hawaiians, and had a lot to say about the culture of using outrigger canoes, as well as just, Hawaiian lifestyle. It's easy to forget that Hawaii is a state and very much a part of American culture. You know, you get all the other connectedness with the world, with this sort of, you know, Western society. And it's made me think about what it means to be connected. Like, the very fact that I'm on the internet means I'm a part of a culture that uses the internet, and as such, all the qualities of that culture pop up in these places that are connected. I mean, you come to an island like Hawaii or Maui, and, you know, it's like, it's resorts, it's Starbucks, there's tourist attractions, there's little tiki men, and, you know, it's very much commodified, and I have trouble reconciling that connection with tourism and that sort of quest for authenticity, which, you know, probably doesn't exist, but you want to believe that things are at least a little bit, you know, real? So I don't know. It's gorgeous in the tropics. What can I say? These are all just first impressions. So I appeared to have lost the quadcopter. We have searched that field just back and forth, doing lines. I don't know what happened. I may give it a few more attempts because I don't think anyone took it. I think it'd be really hard to find this thing because I spent forever looking for it already. But we'll see. It might be gone to the island. Someone spilled tortilla chips at our door last night, probably from above. And they already cleaned it up, but the birds are definitely coming in to feast on the remains. House finch. Here we are at the lavender garden. It smells amazing. It reminds me of like, almost like cinnamon. Nutmeg. Like, I don't know. Something delicious. Lavender.
This is sure attractive.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if it changes color. Provence lavender. Provence.
Capture the detail on these bad boys. Like a white cone. Oh, that's what the cone flower is. It's the Protea king flower. This.
It's like a cool pattern.
Yeah. It's just nature's bounty. Hi.
Okay, now we're going to the...
Oh, yeah, come on.
Well, here we are on top of Haleakala. The Lelele. The Lelele overlook. As you can see, it's a beautiful view. We're up at about, I don't know, 8,000 feet? On our way to the summit.
I remember watching that cloud just come.
This is a very bizarre place.
Now it's cold again.
Yeah. All the plants are very weird. It almost seems like high desert. Yeah, and it reminds me of Oregon too because of all these basalt cobbles. Feels like maybe 60 degrees right now. But I was saying at the lookout that the this is, we're trapped in an inversion layer. The warm trade winds come over the mountain and prevents air from rising from above, so it condenses into a cloud. This is important.
It is important. It's just funny. When you put on your voice.
Silver sword. Your weight injures the silver sword and kills the plants. It sure looks like a silver sword.
The flower's only once in its life.
Hey everyone, Matt Becker here, and I'm here again in Maui. This is day 4, maybe? I don't know. And, yeah, back out of the field looking for my drone. Might be hopeless at this point, but figure I might as well check. Well, today was actually really fun. We went ziplining this morning. You don't need to watch me zipline. It was cool, though. We went up, basically up there, you know. It's, like, very scrub-like. You know, lots of bushes, low-lying plants, lots of this sort of reddish soil. You know, obviously this is all volcano, rusty volcano ash. But yeah, it was a good time. It's ziplining, you know. If you've done it, you know it's fun. If you haven't done it, you should try it because there's nothing really to worry about. Yesterday when I was looking for my drone, I found a dead frog. Maybe I can find it again and show you in the better light. So pretty soon, I'm gonna jump out in the water, I think. Get a little underwater beach footage. We haven't really spent a whole lot of time swimming around the beach. We've just been going so many places. Trying to see the most of the great island of Maui. It's hard not to think about colonialism. You know how I get. Oh, there it is, I found it. Look at this thing. It's huge. It must be like a toad maybe, but it's a really big toad. It's got a bunch of ants crawling in it now. Yeah. Here's something. I found this silicone container yesterday. It's amazing the things that I have found in this field and yet have not found the drone. Oh yeah, there's a rainbow behind me. That's why I stopped. I think you can see that rainbow. It's a rainbow. Hello, and you're watching Matt Becker underwater. The beach is amazing. This is probably the warmest place in the Pacific that I've ever been. It's hard to get warm water in the Pacific. That's it. I'm trying to stay close. Really salty. salty. So salty that I can stay above the water. Easily. It's hard to swim with only one arm though. This is the life. Not quite.
Where to go next? I'm thinking Marrakesh. Or perhaps Iceland? India would be cool. What about Japan?
All right. So it's day 5, and we're on Hana Highway. This is the road to Hana, which is famous for having waterfalls and pools along its route. It gets pretty hairy towards the end. We're not going that far. We're staying on the paved road, but we're about to go to a bamboo forest. So these might be rainbow eucalyptus. Let's see if we can get up close. Oh yeah. Beautiful trees. We're getting bamboozled. Yeah. You know I'm right.
I know you're right.
Oh, I like the way that the light penetrates with these little circles. See all this on the ground?
Yeah.
And the direction of the trail.
Yeah.
It is slippery.
Oh, wow.
Bamboo boo boo. A bamboo boo. Bamboo boo boo boo. We've got one handed bamboo climb.
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's a little fun little bridge. The action crossing of the bridge. So there she is, ready for action. Here's the bridge. It's pretty harrowing. Just do it in one step. Just one, you know, just go boom right across. Look at that. Easy peasy. It's my turn. Wow, it's so tall.
Ooh, that is.
Wow, some of this is pretty thick. Hello.
Hi.
How
are you?
Good.
Good, how are you?
Oh, wonderful.
It's beautiful here.
Is it
cool
in there?
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
Okay.
Three or four waterfalls in there.
Wow. Okay.
Sure. Yeah. Should we go through the mud or go around?
Let's go around it.
Let's go
good.
Around it.
It helped me the whole way.
They're still slippery.
Yeah,
well, let's see. Do we go left or do we go right? I'm guessing we go right. Ooh, pig trails. I'm guessing we go this way.
There, so.
And it's just where water would flow, is my guess. There's a nice little channel that we're about to go through.
Wow.
Oh, yes. What I'm talking about. Here, glasses on. Wow. Oh yeah, we gotta go through the water a little bit.
So this is the kind of spot where you should be aware of
flash floods and where they get the high ground.
Yeah, so
So as we all know, bamboo is an amazing plant.
You
got another?
Oh, yeah.
Here, hook me up. Click. Ah yes, perfect walking stick. Bamboo is a grass. Which is kind of interesting. Probably the tallest growing grass. Grasses originally evolved, I believe, during the Cretaceous into the dinosaur era. But it might have been after. No, Might have been during the Miocene, which was about 25 million years ago. Either way, a lot you can do with bamboo. Makes great flutes. Look at the side here. We need a hand for scale. Bomp. We found it. It's a waterfall.
That's a big honking stone that came down.
Oh, wow. See, yeah, totally. Wow. Look out at that.
Pretty thing.
Wow, Mom, you're giving them a lot.
Hey.
That is a happy kitty. So we're in the town of Paia, and it's a trendy little place. Bunch of little shops, clothing stores, art galleries, stuff like that. Supposedly this is where you can find the celebs. I'm all about the celebs. Fire hydrants in Maui are of a special sort.
Roundy.
And now we're getting fish tacos.
And beer. And sunburns. Oh my god.
You're a little red. Not too bad though.
We didn't get the shady side. Oh well.
I love it. Oh, it's strong. Well, it's our last day in Maui. We basically get the whole day, but by about 10 o'clock tonight, we'll be flying on out of here.